spiritual person, and so I don't know, I connect, I think, to a lot of the themes in the book and the drawings, and I don't know if you guys can relate to it or not. I'm just like curious. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I feel like this book is great for coming of age because it's like Craig's discovery of like everything you read in like Sunday school, you know, it's not, it doesn't always line up to your real world experiences. And I think it's cool talking about what makes, what is sacred to us, because like, you know, it's not always, you know, what they teach you in Sunday school. Like, you know, our sacred and our spiritual moments come in nature. But it's obviously very different from like Craig's views of like religion. And so I want like your guys' like thoughts about what was your first like gut reaction when you saw kind of like the Sunday school teaching, like, oh, you know, hell is a terrible place, and you want to be in heaven, and then the pastor, we're gonna all be in heaven and praise God for like eternity. And this, I also found like this moment where like his parents found the picture of like the naked woman he drew, and like how Jesus kind of like turns away from him. So his view of religion obviously is different than a lot of like, I don't know, maybe not different than a lot of ours, but it obviously changed from his childhood to adulthood, making this book. So what were you guys' like reactions to it?
Not just for him, but for all those other little kids in Sunday school, like how damaging and confusing that must be, just because, I mean, I feel like that's a horrible Sunday school curriculum. I'm like an adult, so just, I mean, like, you can see kind of what it did to Craig over the years. Like, he's confused, and his religion was kind of used to, like, shame him, make him feel guilty, so, like, so bad that all those poor kids, I don't know what church that is, but.
So definitely, yeah, it was like a fear aspect. Yeah. I feel more so than like a loving God aspect. It's very
interesting. I really liked it because I kind of do the same thing. I grew up in like, and my mom went to church, and my brother and I went to Sunday school and church every Sunday, Vacation Bible School. I would still go to that, honestly, but anyway, and one day it was just kind of like, no, like I'm not gonna do this anymore. And I don't know, I just really related to him in that way, and I kind of feel, but I was never treated like that. Like, I was never super strict. Mm-hmm. The curriculum was like, never like that. But more so now, like that I'm here, I kind of get that feeling.
Yeah.
So I really related to it.
Yeah.
Like, in that way. For
sure. I really like. I didn't have necessarily like. I don't remember like my Sunday school being super like that specifically, and my parents weren't like that specifically, but a lot of his struggles, like his reality and religion conflicts he had, I really resonated with, like when he like was first like with Raina, and all he could think about was like it's a sin to like lust. Like all those verses came to his head. And that happened like at a couple other points too, when he's like exploring, and he burned all his drawings because he's told like drawing doesn't glorify the Lord, like you have to sing to glorify the Lord, and like you know, a lot of people that feel a lot of shame in not singing in church, like they're being looked at because they're not singing, but they still are like listening to the words and praying them, just sure, not feel worship. Comfortable. Yeah. Yeah, and so like a lot of his conflict I really felt, and I think that kind of Christianity has been super damaging to a lot of people, especially like for him, and that it's really sad. And I think that it was kind of motivational more for me though to be like, okay, like how can I better teach or represent Christianity to people so that it doesn't happen like that, or so that they don't feel the same way I did at once, or feel the same way he did, where it's Jesus will turn away from you if you think about being human. You know, if you really like actually. Yeah, exactly. Like, and so I thought it was a great representation. I feel like it doesn't, like I think that kids can read it and feel more comfort in what they're going through and not be like, it's not super rebellious, I don't feel like. I feel like it's more like, I think everyone has those thoughts.
Yeah.
lost in translation. Like, everyone questions that, and I think the church tries to not talk about it.
Yeah.
So I appreciated his, like, honest struggle with religion.
Yeah, it seems like a, from what, like, you guys are saying, it seems like a pretty relatable story, especially, like, I don't know, in this, like, private university, Christian university. Do you think...
One more minute.
Okay. Then... Do you think, like, as a graphic novel, like, these pictures of, like, his worship, like, that would have been as powerful in, like, a non-graphic novel style?
I think for him, that was the best way he could represent it, because, like, a lot of graphic novels is hard to think into words. It's so much easier to kind of, like, show what's in your head.
Yeah.
So I think for him, at least, that was the best way he could show what he was thinking.
Yeah, like this page in particular, like, frightened me to my very core, because it's like, it's scary. But yeah, it's like a very powerful experience. This is a great discussion.
Thank you.